Hey guys, Will Morash here again. I'm going to go over the math on this Excel spreadsheet, the pet food calculator that I created. Hang on, this might get a little confusing for some of you guys, but you know, if you're interested in how I come to these numbers, this is how it's done. Number one, you have to find your cost to buy the food. So you simply take the price per bag and divide it by the pounds per bag, and this gives you the price per pound. Now, to get the cost to feed, there's a lot more steps you got to take. First, you have to know the kilocalories per kilogram. Now, these numbers are generally on the side of most bags of food. Some manufacturers don't give you this, and you can either call them or go to their website to get this information. But get the kilocalories per kilogram and divide that by the kilocalories per cup. So basically what we're doing is we're taking the weight and dividing it by the volume. And this gives you the cups per pound. Next, you want to find, you take your price per pound and divide that by the cups per pound, and this gives you your price per cup. So now you know what it costs per cup, and you just, well, if it was that easy, you would simply multiply that by how many cups the manufacturer recommends to feed your pet per day. But as you know, when you look on the side of a bag of food, your dog may be 22 pounds, and there's a category in between 20 to 30 pounds. Or 20 to 35, whatever your manufacturer category is, your dog's weight generally doesn't fit right on one of those numbers, and it might be 1 to 1.5 cups for a 20 to 30 pound dog. Now, obviously you're not measuring that exact cup of food every time, but because we're comparing one brand to another, we have to know what that exact number is so I can tell you exactly what it costs, the difference in our food and their food. So, in order to find this out, we go and we have to, first we'll find your pet's weight on the feeding guidelines and subtract the maximum weight in this weight category from the minimum weight. So let's say your dog's 22 pounds and the weight category is 20 to 30 pounds. You're going to subtract 20 from 30. And this will give you your weight variable. The next thing you want to do is take the maximum cups to feed your pets in that weight category and subtract it from the minimum cups to feed your pet in that weight category. This gives you your cup variable. Now divide the cup variable by the weight variable to give you your cups per pound, we'll call it. Next, subtract the minimum weight in the weight category of your pet from your pet's weight. So let's say your pet weighs 22 pounds, you're going to subtract the 20 pounds from it. And that will give you a number of 2 pounds. This is the weight difference, and we'll call it the weight difference. Now you multiply the weight difference by the cups per pound, and this will give you the additional cups to feed above whatever the minimum recommendation is. So we add the minimum weight in the weight category to the additional cups to feed to get the recommended cups per day to feed your pet based on its weight. Now multiply this number by the price per cup to get the cost per day to feed your pet. I know that's a lot of crazy math. You can go over it again just to let it sink in. And then we simply multiply by, I used 30, an average number of 30 days to get the cost per month. And we multiply the cups per day by the cost per day by 365 to get the cost per year. And then we do that again for life's abundance, and we subtract the difference in those three numbers, the price per day of the two foods, the price per month of the two foods, and the price per year, and that will give you your difference. And then you can see whether your food is cheaper to feed or more expensive to feed than life's abundance, even though life's abundance does appear to be more expensive per bag in most categories. Most times it's actually cheaper. So I hope this is helpful, and if you have any questions, feel free to shoot me an email or give me a call.